Problem. Prove that there does not exist a function f on the natural numbers such that f of n equals n plus 1987 for all n. The first step is to generalize. The origin of this seemingly arbitrary number, 1987, is that this problem comes from the 1987 International Mathematical Olympiad. However, the statement holds for any odd number, and the proof is easier in the general case. We move the hypotheses to the left, and now we need to derive a contradiction. The proof will follow a counting argument that I found on artofproblemsolving.com. We are going to need the fact that f is injective. To prove that, we need to show that if f of x equals f of y, then x equals y. We instantiate hf with x, we rewrite f of x as f of y, and then we instantiate hf with y. Now x equals y follows by cancellation of addition and symmetry of equality. Next, we introduce two sets. A is the complement of the range of f, and B is the image of A under f. An important fact about A and B is that their union is exactly the set of all natural numbers less than 2m plus 1. To prove this subgoal, we set up a two-step calculation. In the first step, we need to prove that A union B is equal to the complement of the range of F compose F. We rewrite B as a difference of two sets, and then we apply the diff union diff cancel theorem, which has some containment conditions on its arguments. The first condition is immediate, and the second follows from an application of the set.imageMono theorem. For the second step of the calculation, we need to show that the complement of the range of F compose F is equal to the set of natural numbers less than 2m plus 1. The extensionality tactic gets us an element x that we need to show is in the first set if and only if it's in the second set. After applying a bunch of rewrites, including an iterated instantiation of hf, we eventually get two matching existentially quantified statements, and that completes the calculation. Now that we have this new way of writing A union B, we also know its cardinality, namely 2m plus 1. Another important fact about A and B is that they are disjoint, because an element of B is in the range of F, and therefore can't be in A. This reasoning is easily handled by the Aesop tactic. Next, we consider the individual cardinalities of A and B. A and B are finite because we already know that their union is finite, and then by finiteness and disjointness, the cardinality of the union is equal to the sum of the cardinalities. It's also true that because F is injective and B is the image of A under F, the two sets have equal cardinality, and we can rewrite B.nCard as A.nCard. Now the left-hand side of this equation is even, and the right-hand side is odd. That's a contradiction, and the omega tactic brings us home.